When we look up at the sky, the vastness of space consumes the mind. It's a truly humbling experience. For millennia, the night sky has captured the imagination of philosophers, artists, poets, and scientists. It's only natural to look up in wonder, in awe. Whether you're new to astronomy and want to learn more about the stars, or you're a seasoned professional, the way that you go about finding an object in space is the same. So how do astronomers locate objects in the sky? They use celestial coordinates. Celestial coordinates are similar to Earth's longitude and latitude, and they are mapped onto an imaginary celestial sphere. The celestial sphere is an imaginary sphere that encompasses the entire Earth. Its purpose is to locate the position of astronomical objects. It is the basis of the coordinate system. Your view of the celestial sphere depends on where you're standing on Earth. The celestial equator is an imaginary circle created by projecting the Earth's equator on the celestial sphere. Because the Earth is tilted on its axis, the celestial equator and poles are also tilted. The north and south celestial poles are the points which Earth's rotational axis would intersect the celestial sphere. The position of a celestial body is described by two angles, right ascension and declination. Right ascension is similar to Earth's longitude. Right ascension is measured in degrees, or hours, minutes, or seconds. 1 hour equals 1/15th degree. 1 minute equals 1/60th degree. 1 second equals 1/3600th degree. Declination is similar to Earth's latitude. The angle of an object is measured above or below the celestial equator. Positive declination refers to objects measured north of the celestial equator. Negative declination refers to objects south of the equator. Declination is measured only in degrees. If you have an equatorial mount with setting circles and you've aligned it to the poles, you can use the right ascension and declination coordinates to locate any objects in space. Please visit our website, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and leave your comments below. Keep looking up at the stars, my friends. See you next time.